Hello dear students, I am Jay Kishan. Welcome to the second part of chapter 10, circles. Students, in the last part of the video we have covered the introduction of the circle, definition of circle, okay, and some basic terms regarding the circle we have covered, okay. So before starting the topic for today, let us revise once again that what we have studied in the last part of the video. Students, how we define a circle, how we give the definition of a circle. Suppose this is the fixed point, the point is O, okay, and from this fixed point at a constant distance, if we take the collection of all the points, okay, if we take the collection of all the points from this fixed point at a constant distance, then the collection of these points, the locus of this point, locus means the path of the points, okay, all these points will be known as the circle. If we take the collection of all the points at a constant distance from this fixed point, then the shape will be known as, the locus of the points will be known as circle, okay students. Now in a circle, the fixed point is known as what? The fixed point is known as the center of the circle, okay, and the constant distance is known as the radius of the circle, okay. So here in a circle what we know that the fixed point is center, okay, suppose it is denoted by O, and the constant distance is radius R, okay students. What else we have studied, that if because of this circle the plane has divided in three regions, okay. The one region, okay, which is outside the circle is called exterior region, okay, and one region is the circle itself, and the one region which is inside the circle, and it is called interior region, okay. The points which are found inside the circle is known as interior point, the point which is found outside the circle is known as exterior point, the point which is on the circle is known as circular point, okay students. So this is how a plane is divided in three regions because of the circle, okay students. Now we have studied about the chord, okay, and what was the definition of chord, that if we join two points of a circle, then this line segment will be known as the chord, okay. This PQ is chord, okay students. So this is the definition of a chord. What is the definition of diameter, okay? See, half of this was the radius, and if we draw the full segment of the line, okay, suppose it is AB, then it will be known as the diameter, okay. And what is diameter? The longest chord of the circle is known as the diameter, okay students. So here the chord we have studied, diameter we have studied. Now what is the arc of a circle, okay? Suppose this is PQ. The continuous piece of the circle is known as arc of the circle, means the piece of the circle. See, the circle is what? This circular region, okay, and if we take the part of the circle, this PQ, which should be continuous, then this PQ will be an arc. Here the arc will be what? PQ. Always we take the direction from anti-clockwise, okay, anti-clockwise means like this, okay. So we'll write the name PQ, and arc PQ will be what kind of mark, what kind of arc? It will be the minor arc, okay, because P to Q is shorter part of the circle, and the longer part is what? QP. The longer part is what? QP. So QP will be major arc and PQ will be minor arc, okay students. So this is how we have defined the chord, this is how we define the arc, okay. Now sector of the circle, okay, what is the sector of the circle? See, द पार्ट ऑफ द प्लेन विच इज कवर्ड बाय द पार्ट ऑफ द प्लेन विच इज कवर्ड बाय एन आर्क ऑफ द सर्किल एंड टू बाउंडिंग रेडियाई देन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द सर्किल इज नोन एज व्हाट सेक्टर. ओके, लाइक इफ वी टेक द माइनर आर्क देन इट विल देन वी विल गेट व्हाट माइनर सेक्टर एंड इफ वी टेक द मेजर आर्क देन वी विल गेट व्हाट द मेजर सेक्टर. ओके, सो द सेक्टर इज ऑल्सो डिवाइडेड इन टू पार्ट, दैट इज माइनर सेक्टर एंड मेजर सेक्टर. वॉट एल्स वी हैव स्टडीड इन द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो, वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द सेगमेंट्स. ओके, वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द सेगमेंट्स दैट द कॉर्ड ऑफ द सर्किल डिवाइड्स द सर्किल इन टू सेगमेंट्स. ओके, सपोज दिस इज द कॉर्ड पी क्यू एंड इट डिवाइड्स द सर्किल इन टू सेगमेंट. ओके, द शॉर्टर वन इज नोन एज माइनर सेगमेंट, माइनर सेगमेंट एंड द लॉन्गर वन इज कॉल्ड मेजर सेगमेंट. माइनर सेगमेंट एंड मेजर सेगमेंट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो दीज टर्म्स वी हैव स्टडीड इन द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो. ओके, दैट द कॉर्ड डायमीटर, ओके आर्क ऑफ द सर्किल, सेक्टर ऑफ द सर्किल, सेगमेंट ऑफ द सर्किल, दीज टर्म्स वी हैव स्टडीड इन द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो. And now we'll start the topic for today. Okay, so let us start, students, the topic for today. And the first topic for today is secant. Okay, what is secant, students? See, if there is a circle and one line is such that which intersects the circle at two points. Okay, if a line is drawn such that it intersects the circle at two points, then this line segment will be known as what? Secant of the circle. Okay, a line, what definition we will write? A line intersecting the circle, a line intersecting circle at two points, at two points is known as secants. Okay, is known as secant. Okay students, so if there is a circle, okay, this is the circle whose center is O. Okay, and this is a line which passes through the circle intersecting it at two different points. Okay, then this type of line is known as what? Secant. Okay students, now in a circle how many secants are possible? In a circle infinitely many secants are possible, because a circle is made by infinitely many number of points. Okay, so there will be infinitely many two points. Okay, and so infinitely many lines can be possible. Okay, so this is what? A secant. Okay, and in a circle infinitely many secants are possible. Now the second one is what? Tangent. Tangent of a circle. Okay, what is the tangent of the circle, students? See, there is a difference between secant and tangent. Okay, secant is what? Secant is the line which intersects the circle at two points. Okay, and tangent is what? Tangent is the line which touches the circle. Okay, tangent is the line which touches the circle at a point. Okay, means at a one point. Okay, see, this line M will be known as the tangent of the circle. Okay, the definition of tangent will be what? A line which touches the circle, which touches the circle at a point. Okay, here example is what? Line L. And here the example is what? Line M. ओके. सो हाउ मेनी टेंजेंट्स आर पॉसिबल इन अ सर्किल? सी, अ सर्किल इज मेड बाय इनफाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स. सो इनफाइनाइट नंबर्स ऑफ टचिंग लाइंस कैन बी पॉसिबल. ओके, सो इनफाइनाइटली मेनी टेंजेंट्स आर पॉसिबल इन अ सर्किल. ओके स्टूडेंट, सो दिस विल बी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ टेंजेंट, दैट इन अ सर्किल इफ अ लाइन इज ड्रॉन विच जस्ट टचेस द सर्किल एट अ पॉइंट, देन दैट टाइप ऑफ लाइन इज नोन एज व्हाट? टेंजेंट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ द टॉपिक इज एंगल सबटेंडेड, एंगल सबटेंडेड बाई एन आर्क. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस. सपोज दिस इज अ सर्कल व्हिच सेंटर इज ओ. ओके, एंड हियर इज द आर्क पी क्यू. दिस इज व्हाट? दिस इज द आर्क पी क्यू. ओके, सो दिस आर्क पी क्यू विल मेक द एंगल. ओके, विल मेक द एंगल एट द सेंटर. सपोज इट इज थीटा. ओके, दिस सिंबल इज व्हाट? दिस, सपोज दिस इज द एंगल थीटा. ओके, एंड दिस आर्क इज मेकिंग दैट एंगल एट द सेंटर एज थीटा. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स व्हाट डेफिनेशन वी कैन गिव हियर? एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय एन आर. व्हाट एक्सप्लेनेशन वी कैन राइट हियर? वी कैन राइट द एंगल विच इज मेड by an arc, okay, at the center by bounding radii is known as angle subtended by arc. Okay, by bounding radii, you can finish your statement here only. Okay, means this arc will make the angle at the center. And how much angle it be? So it is the variable, whatever the name you can give here. Okay, so here it is the angle which is made by the arc. And how you will write the name of that measure of angle POQ. Okay, means this is what? This is the angle POQ. So you can write here that measure of the angle made by arc PQ. Okay students, so this is how an arc make the angle at the center. Okay, now if this angle is theta, then what will be the value of this angle? Okay, see students, this is also an arc, na? This QP is also an arc. Okay, and it is making the angle, whatever the angle it will make, that will be known as the reflex angle. Okay, reflex. Okay, and the value of that will be what? Here it is what? Theta. Okay, angle POQ. Okay, it is what? Theta. So reflex of angle POQ, reflex of angle POQ will be what? 360 minus theta. See, we know that at a point there will be the angle of 360 degree. Means if at the center of the circle, the angle is what? 360 degree. Okay, and if this is the part theta, then what will be the rest of the part? It will be 360 minus theta degree. Okay, so this is 360 minus theta. In the same manner, students, we know that the angle made by the chord. Okay, this, that how chord will make the angle in the same manner, like the angle subtended by an arc. Okay, so just pause the video and note it down these points. One more topic is there, students, that is the congruent circles. Okay, we have studied the congruent triangles. In congruent triangles, we have studied that if two triangles are such that their each and every corresponding parts are equal to each other, then that part are known as congruent triangles. Okay, so this is how the congruent circles also. Okay, if two circles are there. If two circles are there, okay, and both are having, okay, suppose two circles are there and both are having the same radius, means the measure of their radius are same, okay, but the centers are different. Suppose the center of this circle is O and the center of this circle is O dash. But the radius of this circle is R and the radius of this circle is also R. Okay. So the circles having either same center or different center, but their radius should be same. Then that type of circle is known as congruent circle. Okay. See, circles having same radius, okay, are congruent to each other. See, students, this circle, how we can give the name? Circle of center O, radius R. Okay, this is how we can give the name. And this circle, how we can give the name? Circle. Okay, other circle is there. Circle of radius O dash and center O dash and radius R. Both the circles are congruent, so we can denote the with the sign of congruence. That circle of center O radius R is congruent to circle of center O dash but radius R. Okay, both the circles are congruent. Okay, students. One more topic is there, that is concentric circles. Concentric circles. What is the meaning of this? See, students, if at the same center more than one circle is there, okay, of the same center more than one circle is there, then that type of circles, okay, that type of circles are known as what? Concentric circles. Concentric circle means they will have the same center. Okay, they will have the same center. Okay, if more than one circle having their common center, then the circles are known as concentric circles. Okay, students, so just write down these two definitions also. Okay, congruent circles and concentric circles. Okay, students, just note it down with the figure. Now, students, we are going to solve exercise 10.1, and there's only two questions. One is fill in the blanks and other one is true and false. Okay, so that will also you will do in your fair copy in exercise 10.1. okay, now just keep your NCERT book with you. Okay, so that I'm not gonna write all the questions on the board. Okay, I will just tell you what will be the answer. So just keep your NCERT book with you. Okay, so the first question is fill in the blanks, and the question is the center of a circle lies in of the circle. Okay, two options are there, one is exterior and one is interior. So where is the center of the circle, students? I have told you that all the points which are inside the circle is known as what? Interior point of the circle. Okay, if any point is there which is outside the circle, then that will be what? That will be exterior point. So here the center is inside the circle. So the answer of first question, okay, the answer of first question is what? Interior. Interior. Okay. Second part is what? Second part is a point whose distance from the center of a circle is greater than its radius lies in. Now students, you have to think, see, in this circle, suppose it is radius O, okay, and this is the center O and the radius is R. So whatever the points which are inside the circle, okay, the distance of that point, suppose here I have taken one point P, okay, one point P. Students, if the radius of the circle is R, okay, and this point P is inside the circle, then the distance OP will be what? This distance OP will be shorter than the radius. Okay, it is obvious that in a circle, okay, the radius is what? No, see, if we have taken the point P which is inside the circle, and if we extend it to the circumference of the circle, the length will be what? The length will be R, radius. Okay, so it is obvious that OP distance will be shorter than the length of the radius. The question is, if there is any point which is greater than the radius. So if you will take any point which is greater than the radius, it means you are going outside of the circle. Okay. And if you are going outside of the circle, then that point will be what? That point will be exterior point of the circle. Okay. So the second one is what? Exterior. The second point will be what? Exterior. Now coming to the third part. Third part is, the longest chord of a circle is known as. I have told you that in a circle, the longest chord passes through the center of the circle. So if any line which passes through the center of the circle, means the chord of the circle which passes through the center, that will be known as what? Diameter. Okay, I have told you that the longest chord of the circle is what? The diameter of the circle. Fourth part is what? An arc is a dash when its ends are the ends of a diameter. Okay, see students, I have told you this also. Suppose this is A and this is B. They are the end points of the diameter. Okay, so the arc will be what? This arc will be known as what? I have told you na, that arc made by two end points of diameter is known as what? This will be half of the circle, and half of the circle will be known as semicircle. Okay students, so the answer of fourth part will be semicircle. Fifth part is what? Fifth part is, segment of a circle is the region between an arc of the circle. Okay, so see students, segment of a circle is the region between an arc, and segment is what students? Segment is what? Segment is the region between the arc and the chord. Okay, so here it will be in the fifth part, the answer will be what? Chord. Okay, the next one is, a circle divides the plane on which it lies, okay, in how many parts? I have told you that because of the circle, the plane is divided in three parts. One is exterior region, one is circle, and one is interior region. So here the answer will be what? 3. Okay, so now you can note down all the answers of the questions first. Coming to the second question, students, and second question is, write true or false. Okay, So you have to write true or false, and you have to give the reasons for your answer. Okay, so the first part is line segment joining the center to any point of the circle is the radius of the circle. Students, what is the meaning of this question? The meaning is, okay, from the center of the circle, if you will join any point of the circle, then that distance will be known as what? Radius of the circle. It is obvious that the line segment, okay, which is from the center and to the point of any circle is known as what? The radius of the circle. Okay, and what reason you can give? Reason you can give that all the line segment which join the center, okay, all the line segments, see how we have written the radius by the definition of the circle, that from all the collection of all points from a fixed point at a constant distance, and this distance is what? Constant for everywhere. Okay, means the distance will be same. If the distance will be same, then it will be the radius. So here it is true, and the reason, in the reason you will write the definition of the circle, that I have told you that the collection of all points, okay, from a fixed point at a constant distance is known as the circle, and constant distance is known as radius of the circle. Okay, second point is a circle has only finite number of equal chords. A circle have only finite number of equal chords. Now students, I have told you that in a circle infinitely many chords can be drawn. Okay, see, if I have made this chord, okay, so I can make another chord which is of the same length. Okay, I can make another chord which is of the same length. Okay, like this. So infinitely many chords are possible which are of the same length. So this statement is false. Okay, and reason what we'll write, that we can draw infinitely many equal chords. Okay, third question is, so it is the second, the answer of the second is what? False. Okay, and you will write the reason also, because we may draw infinitely many number of chords, equal chords. Okay, so third part is, if a circle is divided into three arcs, each is a major arc. Okay, see students, if we divide the circle in three arcs, okay, so students, I have told you the one greater arc is what? The circle. And if you have divided it in two arcs, then that one is minor and one is major. But if you divide the circle in three arcs, then all the arcs will be the minor arcs. Okay, so here it is wrong. Okay, if a chord is divided in three equal arcs, okay, each is a major arc. No, that each will be the minor arc. Why are you getting my point? If we divide the circle in two equal arcs, then that two equal arcs will be semicircle. But if we divide in three equal arcs, then that three equal arcs will be minor arc. Okay, so this is why the answer of the question is false. Okay, question number four, a chord of a circle which is twice as long as its radius is the diameter of the circle. So students, we all know the formula that diameter is equal to 2 into radius. So if we draw a chord which is twice of radius, then obvious it is a diameter. Okay, so the answer of this question is true. Okay, and in the reason you will write the formula, and you will explain. Okay, the fifth part is, sector is the reason between the chord and its corresponding arc. Okay, chord and its corresponding arc. Students, if we draw a chord, okay, and the corresponding arc, so the reason between this is known as segment of a circle, not a sector of a circle. Okay, so here we'll write that it is false. Okay, because the region covered by a chord and the corresponding arc is what? It is the segment of the circle, not a sector. Okay. Sixth part is what? Sixth part is a circle is a plane figure. Okay, it is true. Okay, I have told you in the beginning, in the starting of the chapter, that it is a 2D figure. Okay, so if it is two dimensional, it is, means it will be on the surface of anything, and if it is on the surface, then it will be plane figure. Okay, students. So exercise 10.1 is now completed. Okay, and for the next exercise, we have to do some theorems. Okay, so in the next part of the video, we will do some theorems. Till then, you have to revise all the topics that I have taught you. Okay, students. So this is enough for today. Thank you, students.